I will talk about the storage of bakery ingredients. Yeast, salt, sugar.
Know that the
proper storage of bakery ingredients is
very important, and there are two
reasons for it. One is availability, and second is the
uniform
production. The baker should have availability of the ingredients
throughout the season,
and so that he can sell his products. There is no shortage of products when there is demand for the bakery goods, and if he is not having the raw ingredients with him, then it will become difficult for him. Therefore, he has to buy the ingredients, for example, flour, yeast, ghee, in one lot, so that it can fulfill his demand for at least few weeks. And when we are storing these raw ingredients, it is very important that we store these ingredients at a proper temperature, at a place which is well ventilated, it has a good or optimum relative humidity, and otherwise the ingredients will be spoiled and the baker will be at loss. Therefore, we take up all these ingredients one by one. First, I take up flour. Flour is very important whether you are making breads or you are making cakes. Baker has to store flour for many reasons. One, I have said, economic consideration. When the
wheat flour is available
in the market at reasonable cost, prices are favorable, then he can buy the flour in one lot. Then he has to buy the flour in big amounts so that when he has big orders at hand, then he has the material to prepare the finished products. Or because at that time sometimes if he places the order, there can be delay, in arrival of the flour, or there can be some other unknown reasons because of which he cannot get his order cleared. That is why it is always good that if he has sufficient stock of flour at hand. Then when we get the flour in a single lot in good amount and we keep it for storage, at that time the color of the flour also improves. We also have to store the flour for its maturing, otherwise we will have to add maturing agents like potassium bromate in this, and these are not used at the mills, flour mills, and when we buy the flour we will have to keep for months together so that flour gets matured before it is used for baking purposes. Therefore,
proper flour
aging requires longer periods, but for that suitable storage space is required. Then there are possibilities that when you store the flour for a longer period, it may get infested.
There is also
a possibility that uneven maturing of the flours may take place in the bags. Therefore, it is always recommended that the baker should store the flour for 2 to 3 weeks from the time the flour is milled. That would be beneficial in certain cases for allowing the flour to complete these few biological changes.
Because these biological
changes, they help in improvement of baking characteristics of the flour.
Because of these reasons,
as I have said, we have to store flour for a few weeks. And while storing, there are certain conditions which should be fulfilled, or we have to keep in mind certain points while storing the flour. For example, the most important number one is ventilation.
Generally, the flour is stored
in the gunny bags, and the
flour storage
room that should be well ventilated,
because if it is
not well ventilated, there will not be free circulation of the air around the piles of the bags. It should also be ensured that in the storage room, moisture doesn't come through the flowers and walls, and the bags should not be directly in touch with the flower. The flower bags, they should be sacked, these sacks of flour should be stacked in such a way so as to have the passage in between the sacks of bags for the circulation of air and also for the movement of the personnel. And it is always better that keep some wooden platform on the floor and then you keep the bags of flour over that. There should not be direct sunlight on the bags. It should be avoided. This is about the ventilation, free passage of air in the room where the bags are stored. Second very important point is humidity. Humidity, you know that the flour has a tendency to lose or gain the moisture from the surroundings depending upon the humidity
in which the particular flour is stored.
If the
humidity is more,
there are chances that the flour may gain moisture. If relative humidity is
less, then the moisture from
the wheat flour will be lost to the surroundings. The ideal relative humidity for storage of flours for long periods is from 55 to 65% when the flour has 12.5% moisture. If the relative humidity is 70%, 75%, then it is required to keep the constantly a flour with 13.5% moisture level. That means it
depends upon the
moisture level of the flour what should be the relative humidity of the storage room.
The flours which have
lower moisture content, for example it has only 11% moisture content, this can be used without detrimental results. In these cases,
addition of proper
amount of water is required while mixing. If the flour is stored near the oven, then also the moisture content of the flour will be lowered down because of the heat of the oven, and it will decrease to such a low level that flour will never
restore the same baking performance.
Therefore, the relative
humidity of the storage room is very important. It should be between 55 to 65%
if the flour is to be stored for a longer time. Under normal conditions, water absorption of flour could be increased by 1.85% for each
1%
decrease of original moisture content of the flour. Similarly, the water absorption of flour that would decrease by 1.85% for each 1% increase of the moisture content of the flour. The baker therefore should keep these factors in mind when the flour is ordered, because moisture content of flour will affect the water absorption properties during the mixing
process
involved in bread making. Then third point is temperature. You know that the temperature of the storage room is also very important, because if the temperature is high, the flour will get matured in a shorter period. And if the temperature is lower, then the flour will take longer time to get matured. Flour stored at high temperature loses certain characteristics, and therefore it will have a poor baking performance. Flour stored at lower temperature will take time to get to the desired temperature of proper aging. Therefore, too low or too high temperature for the storage is not good. The flour should be stored for longer periods at a temperature between
19 to 24 degrees centigrade. Next, fourth point
which we have to keep in mind for storing the ingredients,
that is foreign odors,
especially the flour. Flour absorbs foreign odors very quickly than other bakery ingredients.
Therefore, the flour
should be stored away from the ingredients which
can give
off flavor. For example, oils, spices, onion, garlic, kerosene oil, petrol. All flour can pick up the off flavor of all these products and should not be stored near these products.
Otherwise, you will
find these odors in the finished products also.
These are the four main
points which you have to keep in mind while storing the flour: temperature, relative humidity, foreign odors, proper ventilation. These all are very important, and one should store the flour keeping into consideration
all these points. Now we come to the
second ingredient, that is yeast.
Storage of yeast. When you know that
yeast, it is Saccharomyces cerevisiae. It is also known as baker's yeast.
It is a living organism.
It has living cells. If there is any negligence in handling the yeast, it
can possibly
ruin a portion of it or whole of the pack of yeast. Therefore, it is suggested that yeast should be
obtained
as fresh as possible, because old yeast will not give good result. It will not have the dough-raising properties. Therefore, we should
store and handle
the yeast
properly. We get yeast as active
dried or compressed yeast or as instant yeast.
Baker's active dried or compressed
yeast should be used in rotation
so that the older stocks
are used before we get the new stocks.
The yeast should not be
subjected to extreme heat even for the shortest period of time. Dried yeast should be stored at a cool place,
preferably at a temperature
ranging from 1 to 10 degrees centigrade. Therefore, it should be kept in the refrigerator.
However, when
using the compressed yeast which has been kept in the freezer, it should be thawed out first, and then the thawing has to be done slowly so that there is not abrupt change in the
temperature of
the yeast, and otherwise the yeast cells will be ruptured very quickly.
Therefore, slowly we have to
thaw, and then we have to use the yeast.
Compressed yeast has to be kept, fresh yeast, it has to be kept
always in the deep freezer.
But active dried
yeast we can keep in any compartment of the refrigerator, which is between 1 to 10 degrees centigrade.
When you are using the dried yeast, lid of the tin of the yeast must
be replaced soon after used. It should not be kept open for longer periods. Whenever you take out the yeast, immediately
you place lid on the tin or
the bottle, so that it is not exposed to the air for a longer time. The
baker active
compressed yeast,
it is a perishable commodity.
The compressed yeast will lose little fermenting power when it is refrigerated at about 1 degree centigrade even. It should not be stored more than 4 to 5 weeks. And however, the compressed yeast can be stored for months in the frozen state, but once you have thawed it out, it cannot be kept for more than 2 to 3 weeks.
And
therefore, as you know, that compressed yeast, it is a perishable in nature, and therefore the package which contains this yeast
should not be exposed
to the humid conditions for a longer time, and it should not be stored at a warm atmosphere, because at the warm atmosphere it can get contaminated with the other organisms, and like fungus and other bacteria, they can contaminate the yeast and they will bring about certain changes in the yeast
itself, and these changes will be noticeable when you will feel the flavor
of the yeast, and it will not give good
flavor to the products also, and moreover the gassing
quality of the yeast will also deteriorate.
When you are dispersing the active dried yeast
in water having a temperature of about 35 degree centigrade, always be around 27, 28 or 35 degrees centigrade, up to that, not beyond that, because higher temperature will hinder the growth of the yeast, they will hinder the functioning of the yeast, and the yeast will not be able to work
to its optimum. All these
factors have to be keep in mind when you are storing and working with different
kinds of yeast. Then the third
ingredient is fat,
because use margarine
or they use butter or they use hydrogenated fat. All these different kinds of fats are used in the baking.
Fats and oils,
they should be stored in cool, dark, clean places which are away from the ingredients
which have very strong flavors,
because the fats also absorb the smell and odors of spices or petroleum products, all those products which have strong characteristic odor. Perishable fats like butter, it should always be refrigerated.
When you are using
cooking oils which are polyunsaturated in nature,
they should be also stored at a
comparatively lower temperature, not at very high room temperature, and they should be used within the prescribed limit, otherwise they will start giving rancid flavor.
Baking powder is
essential ingredient
in confectionery,
baking cakes and all those things, and baking powder should also be stored in the containers which
have
which can be closed properly, if they have proper lids which can
be tightly closed,
and the so that the possible losses do not occur due to spillage, and they do not absorb moisture from the atmosphere if the packing is loose.
They should always be kept in the tight lid
containers.
Then sugar can be stored at room temperature,
and but at the same time it should be packed properly. It should not be stored in a damp room, because you know that sugar is hygroscopic, it will absorb moisture from the environment, and therefore the
sugar should be stored in the tight
containers and should be kept at proper room temperature where the moisture content is not very high, and this room is not having dampness. Then there are critical storage temperatures and norms for the raw materials. For example, I let you know that flour, this should be the optimum storage temperature is around 38 to 40 degree Fahrenheit.
Bread, it is 60 to 65 degree Fahrenheit.
Fruits, dry products, dried fruits, if using,
they should have 40
degree Fahrenheit storage temperature.
Similarly, if you're using milk,
it should always be fresh if it's a liquid milk.
Fresh, compressed yeast, 37 to 40 degree Fahrenheit. Liquid eggs, egg albumins, 5 to 15 degree Fahrenheit. All these wax paper
for packaging,
50 to 60
degree Fahrenheit.
These are the adequate temperatures
for storing material used
in the bakery.
Bread, you know, it depreciates
and stales rapidly
at the cold weather. The temperature between 60 and 65 degree Fahrenheit has been found to be most suitable temperature because maximum flavor is retained at this temperature and staling is also
minimum
at this temperature. Hygroscopic substances like malt extract or the substances which depreciate during exposure to air, for example milk, butter, baking powder, they should be always stored in the airtight containers, otherwise they will get deteriorated.
There are certain
packing materials also which are to be used for these ingredients,
and
for example compressed yeast, it is always wrapped, and dried yeast or active yeast, this comes in the tins. White bean premixes, they also
come in the boxes.
Tutti frutti's, candies,
candied fruits,
they all come in the tins. And wheat flour, jute gunny bags, similarly
atta,
whole wheat flour, it's again stored in jute gunny bags. Salt, preferably it should be in the
gunny bags which
have polyethylene liner inside. Sugar, jute gunny bags. Vegetable oils, this comes in the tins. Bakery fat, vanaspati, they also comes in the tins.
GMS powder, this is again poly-lined gunny bags.
Potassium bromate, it comes in the plastic bottles or flexible packed, in turn packed in cardboard boxes. Defatted soya flour, if you're using,
it should be in the polyethylene bags.
And all these ingredients,
they should have the proper packing
material,
and they should be stored at the optimum
conditions for the desirable time period at a desirable temperature and relative humidity.
Then only you can use those ingredients for making breads or confectionery items, which will give good result. If the ingredients have not been stored
properly, then there are chances that they may not yield good results.
That is why
the storage of raw ingredients used in bakery is very, very important. Thank you. Thank you very much.